People have been waiting years and years and years and years and more years to see the Moonies Dragster back out. And the retro vintage awesome goodness folks at Atlantis have reissued it. This thing is a small box, but you're not going to believe all the stuff that's in here. The things like buying multiple parts packs, and you get to assemble an entire model from it too. Made in the USA, molded, boxed, everything in the USA. They've got an awesome picture of the built model on the back of the box for you so you can see what it should look like when you're all done. Retro box art. Let's take a look at everything that's inside the box. First up will be Atlantis's excellent, superb decal sets. It's not a large set, doesn't need to be. This is a Dragster. But what's nice is their decals are super thin. They release from the paper nicely, and I haven't had one rip yet. So those are always nice. They lay down beautifully. Newly tooled tire package. They must have cut down the tire tree that these grew on, so they had to make new ones. I love how they're molded. It's like a textured mold instead of smooth. They look like real rubber. They feel like real rubber. They kind of smell like real rubber. And I don't think you even have to sand those, but we'll see if I can. The rears are solid. The fronts are solid. I don't see any name brands on them, but check out that texture all the way around. Pretty sweet, and you can always get tire decals later. One, two big chrome trees. Look at all the stuff on here. You can clearly see that there will be extra parts. And there's no way all of these are going to be used on the Moonies to build it as it is from the box. It's just simply not going to happen. Beautiful amount of extra parts. Extra wheels. We got knockoffs. We got all kinds of tiny parts. All wheels, inner wheels. I mean, just a beautiful package there. This right here is a $15 part pack. Let's take a look at the instructions real quick. I have never seen ones like this, and they're awesome. Gives you your exploded view with the proper names for all the parts, which people that, you know, want to know the exact name are going to like. And then it gives a picture of the parts tree with all the numbers on it. In case you can't identify it by looks, tells you exactly where to find it. Even B&M hydro transmission, and wording, very vintage style directions. Like that kind of stuff. Tells you how to go through your final assemblies, as always, and decal placement. Let's take a look at the styrene that isn't chromed. Such little parts, and so many of them. Look at that, two different types of steering wheel. Look at the molding on that little one. We got brake backing plates, suspension, moon tanks, linkages. Just lovely. So finely detailed. We got some frame rails here. Exhaust, maybe another axle. Got a floorboard. Yeah, I mean, there's, like I said, there's absolutely no way that this little Dragster uses all these parts. So you've got a lot of spare parts in this thing. We've got the bodywork. We've got the main chassis. You can see they've also looked at the molds to make sure everything's in great shape. These used to be kind of softly molded. Now they're really crisp. Don't see any big flash webbing. You get little stuff like this, but that just peels off, snaps off, cuts off with a knife. There's no big closed off parts of the frame, which can be frustrating to open up. And then we've got our seat and different parts. And that is it. I shouldn't say that's it, because that is a lot of stuff in that little box. And you're going to have a lot of parts left over if you like to save parts for custom builds. So I'm going to start putting together my Moonies, and I'll be right back. Let's take a look at where assembly gets you and why I said this thing is like a parts kit all in itself in the box. If you're going to be building the Moonies as it is from the box, all of this stuff in the back is left over to use for what you want. So, I mean, frame rails, we've got floor pans, we've got linkages, we've got small little dashboards there, we've got roll cage parts, all kinds of things, Pitman arms, I mean, just a plethora of parts. We got wheels, two. We got knockoffs that'll be left over. We're only going to be using two on this car. We've got all kinds of hubs. I mean, just outstanding. We got an extra steering wheel. We got drum brake parts, or we got wheel back parts. We got an extra moon tank in here. We've got springs, linkages. We've got an entirely additional spool. I accidentally cut one part of it out, but there's part of the spool, and here's the wider axles. We've got more linkage. We've got track bars. We've got shock absorbers. Amazing. Everything that's extra in that kit. And chrome parts. We've got an intake. We've got some carburation. We've got a belt and pulley and fan system. We've got a water pump here. We've got some small air cleaners, it looks like. And all kinds of other stuff. So, huge parts pile for those of you that like to collect parts and custom build vehicles and whatnot. We'll look at what goes into the Mooneyes right now. We've got the seat that's on its own tree, so I can get that painted separately. We've got the spool in the back end, the quick change rear end. This is the narrow one, and it assembles nicely. I'm glad that it's white plastic. We've got the pipes for the blower, because it's a forward sitting blower. So those chrome pipes will go on last. We've got the pitman arm for the steering on the Mooneyes. We've got the bottom plate. This goes across. This is the rest of the bodywork for the car. It goes on the very bottom, but you can't put the axle in if this is in the way. So this will get painted up separately and then attached. These are little arms to attach another moon tank. So we've got all kinds of spare parts. These parts right here, here's our upper intake. For the front-mounted blower, you can see those pipes sticking out of the front. And our zoomies and our magneto is on this tree as well. You can see it's sticking up from the bottom there. So that's will be on there in the chrome. And our valve covers, all of that needs black washes and a little bit of work on it. We've got our steering box and our steering wheel. These look like goggles. Put those on, but that's how it looks in the Mooneyes. So that's how we've got it all set up. We got to get paint on that. The wheels are assembled. They're just pressed together so I can take them apart at any time to work on them and clean up that chrome edge a little bit. But that's how they look. They are sharp looking. They definitely need a wash so you can see more detail in there. That's the back of them. They just friction fit into those awesome retooled tires. These ones won't be touched at all except maybe a black wash around the edge and in the very center, but as they are very good looking. I may not even do that at all. Very nice spoke wheels, two halves, slide onto the front axle. The front axle is right here. They have you assemble it, and thankfully it's white plastic. This will just glue into the hooks on the front of the chassis. This part mounts to a rod on the bottom of the chassis, we'll see. This is your steering, and that's your tie rod in there. So that's your front axle assembly. We can just hang on to that, get it painted. I use model glue and super glue to sort of tack weld the parts together while the model glue dries. Now here's our main body. It is a little finicky. We'll go through the parts and all that stuff. I think even, you know, an adult beginner to models could do this. A kid, if you got this for a younger kid, might want to help them out or might want to let them do some regular kits and then get to this. But you probably want to buy it just to get all those extra parts over there and then let them finagle with it. So we'll start disassembling it. We've got our hood, firewall, and I guess you could call it the dashboard. I'll be painting this all body color. On the box art, the firewall is metallic. So I will go through, I like hand painting, and I will hand paint that a metallic. I did want to glue it in. I do like that they have these large tabs to join the two halves of the hood together. And then it has grooves to put the dashboard and the firewall in. Then I took some putty. I don't usually fill in seams, but this one was a deep enough one that I just filled it with some automotive putty. And I know you're going to ask, so I'll get it. You can buy it at Walmart for like, I don't know what it is nowadays, but years ago it was $5 a tube. That stuff right there melts itself into the styrene, joins with the plastic. A tube like that, even if you fill every single seam, if you're a much better modeler than me, that tube over there should last 10 years. So I filled that in a little bit, sanded it a little bit. I can still kind of feel it, but it's not as bad, so whatever. Good enough for me. The chassis is as such. We'll take the fuel tank out. Well, we'll take the engine out, then I can get the fuel tank out. So you saw the engine sitting in there. The entire engine is chrome. The cloudiness you see is super glue and activator, and I didn't worry about that on this one. Future floor polish won't cover that much up, but this is all getting painted. Then I'll hand paint the transmission, but the transmission is two pieces. The bell housing is one. The oil pan, the block, the cylinder heads, and the upper parts of the block, all separate pieces, and the blower adapter for the front, another separate piece. Lots of stuff going on here. So I glued it all together with super glue, activator, and we'll get that painted, and then I will hand paint my details. I also glued in the mounts for the zoomies on the side, so I can just push them in and attach them and align them, and I wouldn't have to try to rebuild that onto the zoomies and then attach it later. That's not for me. Front mounted blower, you can see this is the part that attaches to the back of the, or the front of the engine with those spikes on the adapter. And then we've got our air hoses. We'll plug into those holes right there and go back to the top of that intake right there. And then we've got our fuel injectors on this side to suck it all in and blow it down the throat. So that is that. That's going to get repainted completely by me with a lighter metallic color. The chassis itself, we'll get the moon tank out. That's what those plastic ones look like when you assemble them. We'll get those metallicized. They're going to look awesome. Nice little fuel tank in the front there. And then the chassis. Yes, I already glued the motor mount in there. The cross brace, the front brace. You can see all the sides attach. They've got nice pegs on the inside. Look right over my fingertip. Right over my fingertip on the other side. Those will help you align those side panels of the body. You can put the upper roll cage piece in, this front ring, because the seat will still press in through here. Then we will start attaching everything. So that is nice looking chassis. For the most part, it's pretty straight. What's nice about it is if it's not completely straight once you glue that front axle on, when you slide your rear axle in, it's a very tight fit. If you have any tweak, just leave one side a little higher than lower. The tires will block a lot of the vision, so you won't be able to see it, and your dragster will sit completely level. So your tip from Uncle Chris for the day, just fudge it a little bit before you glue that axle in, and you won't have to worry about it sitting up like it's on its side. That's a nice looking chassis, the body panels and everything. This top hood panel will press in between, and then we will slide it all the way forward and glue it into place so it's a smooth assembly. That'll be one of the very last things we do just before decal time, is we'll get that. It's a tight wobbly fit that pops out really easy. So we'll get that in there. We'll get it evened out. When I did mine, there's a gap between the two. You can kind of see a lip over. I really can't do anything about that. When I looked at the box art, they're kind of doing the same thing, but they've put a lot of body work into this thing to clear that seam, clear that side seam, but you can still kind of see that lip there. So I'm not worried about that at all. It's just a basic kit review, not a show build. So now that we've talked about all the pieces and parts and showed everything off, it is time to hit the paint booth. The hits just keep on coming from the folks at Atlantis who bought massive amounts of the old Revell molds in which they found all kinds of stuff like the Mooneyes Dragster. This thing is sweet. As you can see, didn't need to make any adjustments. She sits on all four tires, looks lovely. There is so much detail in this little kit, so many small parts. This is the first kit I've ever built with a blower out in front. I know that they were a frequent thing. I know there's other models of like Fiats and stuff, but this is the first one I've built, and you can see everything, which makes it even cooler. Those newly tooled tires, front and rear, thumbs up. Real rubber, they've got gorgeous texture all the way around. I could see people buying it for that. You got four trees left over with spare parts for dragsters and coupes and customs or whatever. You got frame rails, all that stuff I showed. Definite awesome kit. And it's not even that big of a box. They managed all those parts in there. Over 100 parts, and you're not going to use all of them on the dragster. Not even close. Goes together super nice. You should have a little more model experience because the parts are so small. They're very intricate, but you could build it. The youngsters, or a beginning adult, could build the kit. The youngsters, I don't recommend it for youngsters unless they really know what they're doing with models, or if you're standing right there with them to guide them through. It's just because of the size of the part, not the quality. Everything goes together fine. It's just stuff is so very small, and it's intricate detail. You saw I went and added black washes around the edges of things. That's the show where two parts will come together. There's always a shadow in between them, no matter what you do. And I like to do that with the black wash, especially on dragsters where it's all exposed. Did a little anodized coupling on there. I know it's not like that on the box, but I just wanted a little bit of different color. And I like the blue, you know, for air. And I just wanted to put that in there like that and have it, you know, just as a little focal point when I look at the car. Otherwise, lots of fun to put this one together. Didn't take me any longer than 2 days, my normal build time. This one was done way in advance of that. Got it all pushed together. That seat you can put in after you glue the roll cage together. You can glue the entire chassis and the sides together and then work on everything and straighten it out. Then you put your front end on, slide that differential in. That differential is held in with friction only and can be adjusted if you ended up tweaking the frame a little bit or didn't quite get that front axle together perfectly straight. You can cheat a little bit with that rear axle by tweaking it side to side because it's not glued in. So thanks, Atlantis, for sending this over. Atlantis has it in stock. Model Roundup has it in stock. I will link down below. You can snag that kit immediately. I thank them for sending these kits over. We've got other ones from them to build. And if you follow their Facebook page, you see all the amazing stuff coming out for next year and the rest of this year. I hope to get most of those and get a chance to build them up. Thanks to you for being cool viewers. Build for you. If you don't want to build the Mooneyes, just build yourself something out of all the parts in that box. That's why I do the parts review in the beginning, so you can see that there's more than just the Mooneyes in there. There's almost two complete vehicles in that box. So thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see all of you at the next review. We'll be right back.